trying a different angle today. Having the phone on a different angle today, so hopefully. Whoa, fuck! Sorry, guys. Can you see me better? Mic check, 1, 2. Okay, so the phone's at a new angle. Hopefully, you guys like this approach. I'm gonna be talking about going back to sort of a series of videos talking about Smegma. I was just on the Smegma WhatsApp group chat, and someone brought up a very interesting question that I thought I'd address in video, and I could send it to the group chat, and also people online that are into Smegma could stumble across this video. It's actually not around the taste of Smegma, and it's not around the formation of Smegma and how to get the build up. It's actually, for a change, a little bit of a science lesson for you people that are a little bit less educated than myself on Smegma. We're going to be talking about the digestion of Smegma and the nutrients that can come from Smegma. So, when your body is trying to digest it, obviously, all right, let me start from the beginning. Stomach is filled with lactic acid and a little bit of hydrochloric acid, and the stomach is technically a second brain. So, one way I like to think about this is, if our first initial real brain is into the idea of eating Smegma, then surely we can convince our second brain, our stomach, into the idea of digesting the Smegma. So, the same way that you want to go out and you want to eat a packet of crisps, a packet of candy, a packet of chocolate, the same way you want to go out and drink a can of beer, drink a can of soda, the same way you want to enjoy that yummy raisin, the same way you want to have that tasty snack, you convince your brain it's the right idea, and your brain then convinces your stomach, this is the right idea, please process this food for me. It's when you start to get too drunk or you eat too much that you begin to feel sick, and your brain stops telling your stomach, digest it. Your stomach begins to play up, begins to be silly, and this can lead to nausea, vomiting, headaches, migraines, cancer, bellyache, feeling sick, being sick, not being able to get a boner, and having a bad time. So what you need to do before you even think about putting that Smegma in your mouth, tell yourself, I'm gonna be okay. I'm gonna cope with this Smegma. I'm not gonna feel sick when I eat this Smegma, even though it smells. I understand the nutritional value of it, and I understand that this is a good choice for me to be making. For me to eat this Smegma is a more wise choice than for me to discard the Smegma and throw it down the drain. Okay, so one way I like to train my belly to handle Smegma is by eating food that has a similar texture, so that I can get used to, you know, moving it around my mouth with my tongue, rubbing the Smegma on my upper palate, and, you know, getting it all stuck in my teeth. One thing I like to do, I like to practice with cream cheese. So I'll buy some Philadelphia cream cheese, and I'll put a tiny bit on my tongue, and I'll move it all around my mouth, and I'll be looking at pictures of penises with high Smegma on them, a lot of Smegma covering the tip, and I'll move the cream cheese around my mouth, and I'll just be psyching my stomach up for getting ready for that, you know. Convince the brain it can handle it, and the stomach does the rest of the work. You don't even need to put your hand in your pocket. You don't need to spend anything other than buying the cream cheese. And this technique will get your body ready to be digesting Smegma in a matter of no time, in a matter of seconds. And also, you get a yummy cream cheese snack while you're practicing. Who can say no to a yummy cream cheesy snack? I couldn't say no to cheese cream snacks. Fuck. Anyway, yes. So I have jotted over the nutritional value of Smegma in previous videos, and I plan to do a whole series on the nutritional value, so I won't get too into that in this video. I'm just talking about the digestion, and so the acids, the stomach acids, they will meet the Smegma. But the thing is, Smegma is usually in such small quantities that it can almost just get lost in transport. Okay, you can be swallowing that Smegma, and it can just grip onto some of the fine hairs on the inner neck, near the jugular, and if this does happen, your stomach will not be digesting that Smegma, or it may eventually reach it but in a more liquid form, and it may not give off as much nutritional value as it could have done in solid form. So my number one thing that I would suggest before you even think about having the smegma is building up a lot of it, because a little bit, like I said, could get caught and you could lose it and you won't get that nutritional value, and you've eaten that smegma for absolutely zilch, for no reason, for nothing, for no reason at all. Okay, so you want to eat a lot of smegma. My advice for you guys out there would be to build up over a period of time, maybe 3 or 4 weeks, removing the smegma once a week and putting it in somewhere safe. You don't want to lose your smegma, and put it somewhere that's smell proof, because you don't want to smell it either. And once you've got maybe a month's worth of it, you could either then have it and get a tiny spoon or a tiny knife and use it as like a paste. They put it on a cracker. Smeggen crackers, yummy. Or if you want to, if you're a bit more of a daredevil, you could compress it into a pill form and take that pill. You could take that smegma pill. People say red, blue, or blue pill. I say smegma. So if you guys agree with me, please comment below, smegma pill. And if you've ever tried this, let me know like what you think of it. I'm an avid fan of the smegma pill, but I get less enjoyment because I can't taste it. I know my first 10 smegma pills, or first 5 years of loving smegma, I didn't even like the taste of it. So I was more inclined to do the smegma pill. Now I'm obsessed with the smell, obsessed with the taste. I just think it's a luxury, and I'll take my time to eat my smegma. I like to turn it into a paste and just put it on my tongue, and I open my mouth and leave it on my tongue for half hour. Just, you know, let the smell get into my lungs, and yeah. But anyway, guys, this is whatever. This is just a little video for the group chat, and I'll probably put this on the YouTube channel too. I'm not sure yet, but yeah, if you guys see this, please leave a thumbs up. It means a lot. I'm almost at 80 subscribers now, so we're actually climbing up the YouTube ladder, and in no time I'm going to be up there with the ranks of Jake Paul, Fortnite, Garfield, and Max Mofo. So thanks for watching this video, and I'll peace out.